Good evening, everyone. For those who have attended my morning session, welcome back. Again, we are going to start with beginner level cardio session, and with this workout, you are going to burn somewhere around 500 to 1000 calories, depending on how closely you are following me. Okay. So, as with every workout, we are supposed to start with the warm-up exercises. Benefits of the warm-up exercise is that it actually increases your blood circulation in the body, and you can actually get ready and you can just away from all kind of injuries. Alright. So we are just going to start with a very basic warm-up exercise. We are going to start with the arm rotation. Okay. Just stand like this, or I can just do this way. Yeah, and just take the arm rotation clockwise 10 times. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Anti-clockwise. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, some neck to neck, neck side to side rotation. Keep your hands on the, your waist and sideways. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, we can just do the some mobility drill for your wrist also. Just keep your hand in front and just pick the 10 counts of clockwise and then 10 clock of anti-clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Anti-clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we are moving towards our hip joint. Okay, this is very much important. You have to open up your hip joint whenever you start any sort of exercise. Just keep your hand here, clockwise 10, anti-clockwise 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, anti-clockwise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is for your specifically for your hips joint, and it is very much important. Now we are moving towards our ankle joint. Okay, same way for obese person, if they are not able to balance it, you can just hold the ball, keep your one leg forward, take it down and just make some clockwise and anti-clockwise 10 counts. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Anti-clockwise, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Same way you can go with the left leg also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Anti-clockwise, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we are good to go for our workout phase. Now we are done with our warm-up phase. So guys, whenever if you want to be injury free, you just have to more focus towards the warm-up first. This is the very most important part of our workout. If you are doing any sort of, if you don't have the time, make sure that you do the warm-up and then you just start with your workout phase. Now we are moving towards workout phase. So I'm going to show you some 5 to 6 exercises. For every exercise, we are going to do 3 sets and we are going to take rest period as minimum as possible. So I'm just going to take only 15 seconds break in between each set, and so that I can perform the next exercise. Okay. Now we are starting with the crisscross jack exercise. So basically this is a modified version of the jumping jacks. Okay, and it is going to be a little bit intense, but just see and watch me how I am doing it. Alright, now for this, you just have to keep your left shoulder width apart. Okay, so now we are starting. So you can keep your hand like this also. So I am just showing you this one. 10 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you can see this exercise particularly works on your quads, your inner thighs, your glutes, and your abdominal part. Okay, so make sure now if you want to make it much more functional, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to do some upper body movement also. All right, so it will be really helpful for like upper body as well as the lower body. Now we are going to start with our second set. Here I'm going to use my upper body. I'll show you how to use the arms while doing the crisscross jerk. Just keep it same again, shoulder width apart, your legs, hands in forward, and now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So as you can see that when I use my upper body also, it become much more functional. So it is very much important that the more functional exercise you do, it will be very good for your metabolism, to increase the metabolism. Okay, now we are going to start with the third set of the crisscross jerk. So the people who is obese, so they don't have to use the upper limb, they just do the lower. Alright, now we are starting with our third set. So for obese person, they can follow this. Again, shoulder width apart, keep your toe outside, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is our third set of crisscross jerk. Now so many people have so many questions regarding the fitness, regarding how to increase our cardiovascular endurance, or in a normal terminology you can say as stamina, and plus how to increase our metabolism. So guys, there are certain things that you need to really take care of it, that when it comes to the stamina and metabolism, it is a long process. It is not going to increase overnight. The people who think that they can increase it overnight, it is not possible. It's completely a myth. All right. Let me have a sip of water, because I told you whenever your body feels dehydrated, just have a sip of water. Now we are going to start with our second exercise, that is known as high knee skip. So basically for this exercise particularly, you, if you have the long terrace or if the larger space, you can just take the momentum. Alright, so basically you have to lift your one knee up and opposite hand forward, and you have to run it forward. Like you can use it 1, 2, 3, 4. Again you can go back and you can again just start the running. 2, 3, 4. In this way you can continue. So in the standing position, you can do simply 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So again, this exercise is again good for your quads, your hips, and your core engagement. For every exercise, our lower body and plus core is very, very much important. And I tell you how to increase the, you can say the stamina in normal terminology. So basically, people who think that if they do only cardio, they can increase the endurance. No, you have, it has to be a mixture of both the things, your weight training as well as the cardio. Okay, so once you follow this both routine, your weight training should be followed by the cardio. This is the right approach if you want to go for it. All right, now we are starting with our second set. All right, ready guys? 10 counts on the standing position. If same, one, same. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect. So this was our second set for high knee skip. Alright, and plus I was talking about the endurance, how to increase the stamina. So for this, try to make sure you can see the rest period. When you're taking the rest period in between the set, that is most important what you want to achieve. Alright, so what you can do, just try to take the minimum rest period, so that it will be very challenging for the heart as well as for the working muscles, and it will increase your resting metabolism. Okay, so make sure to take a very less rest period in between the set. Now we're starting with our third set. Same way, I'm just showing the standing position. The guys who have the larger space, they can just run and then they can complete the entire set. All right, now third set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this was our third set. And I told you the importance of this exercise. It is very good for your abdominal, your thighs and your buttocks. So another way how you can increase the stamina, you can basically, you can do the HIIT training. So basically what I'm showing you right now, it is just a smaller version of the HIIT. The more advanced, or you can say the intermediate person, it will be very good for them, and it will really gonna help you to increase your metabolism or your cardiovascular endurance. All right. Now we are going to start with our third exercise, that is known as high knee with slight hop. All right. So in this exercise, basically you are going to work your upper body as well as the lower body. Okay. So you have to just take the knee up and you have to just hop. All right. Again, knee up and then hop. So we are going to do 3 sets of this exercise. So you can just keep your arms over your shoulder like this, or you can have, if you have the bottle or if you have the dumbbell, if you want to make it much more intense, you can use it in this way. All right. So just take your knees up and one, up, still, up, three, up, four, up, five, up, six, up, seven, up, eight, up, nine, up, 10. So this was our first set, and this exercise is really good for you. If you want to tone up your arms, it will be really helpful for you. Plus, if you, the person who is having the knee problem, they can do this exercise, it will be very good for them. Okay, so make sure the people who don't have any kind of orthopedic injuries, they can use the dumbbells, or they can use the even water bottle if you don't have the dumbbells as a replacement to do the upper body rotation also exercises. Now we are going to start with our second set for the high knee with slight hop. All right, same again, coming to the same position, just see my knees, okay, and my hips. All right, one, still, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So this was our second set for the high knee with slight hop. Okay. So this exercise is again good for your arms and the lower body. And the another way that you, if you want to increase your cardiovascular endurance or stamina, you can actually, if you go to the gym, you can select the compound exercise over the isolation. Compound exercise means, suppose if you are doing the squats. So if you are doing the squats like this, you can see that my hip joint and my knee both are working together. So this is known as compound. And if you do just only biceps curl, suppose if you are doing only biceps curl, alright, so only one joint is working. So this is known as isolation. So always select the compound exercise over the isolation. And it actually depends on your fitness level. If you are a beginner, then compound movement will be a little bit difficult for you, little bit challenging for you. Always start with the isolation movement. Okay, so that if you are doing it for the first time, you will not get any kind of injuries, any kind of orthopedic injuries. Now we are starting with our second set. Alright. So basically, as I mentioned that in this exercise, you just have to more focus on the form. That is very much important. Just keep it up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, step. So this was our high knee with slight hop. Okay, now if we talk about the metabolism, so basically everybody has a different metabolism. Everybody has a different metabolism. The terminology is known as BMR, basal metabolic rate. So when your body is at rest, the amount of energy that your body used to do the work, that is known as BMR. The person who is obese, they have a less BMR, okay? And as our age advances, our BMR goes down, slowly steady, okay? Now, how to increase this metabolism? So first of all, guys, never ever cut down the calorie drastically, okay? Because it actually lowers down your resting metabolism, and that is not at all good for the body, okay? Our body is not meant in this way. So if you will cut down, your body will understand that you will go into the starving stage, and your body will start eating the muscle, and that is not at all good. Now we are going to start with another exercise, squat and knee raise, okay? Again, this exercise is going to work on your thighs, your glutes and your core. Just keep your toes slightly hip width apart, okay? You have to do the squats and you have to do the knee raise, okay? So either you can keep your hand like this or you can keep your hand in front. Squat and knee raise. One. Two. Three. Keep your chest as much as possible high. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So you can see this exercise, it is again, you can see compound exercise. Basically, I'm doing the squat, so I'm using my hip joint as well as my knee joint. Okay, so for this exercise, the people who is having knee problem, they please make sure that they don't push themselves. The people who is getting the ACL, recently they got operated, please don't do this exercise. You can just try to take your knee up. That is much more important, alright? Now, we are going to start with our next set for the squat and knee raise, alright? Again, you have to come into the same position. Your toes slightly just in line with your slightly wider than the hips, alright? To our side, keep your hand in front. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, step. This was our second set for squat and knee raise. Because when people think that if they are sweating, that means they are burning the calorie. There is nothing like this concept, guys. It is just normal body response, okay? There is nothing to do with sweating with your intensity of the workout. Alright? So please make sure, if you are not sweating, that doesn't mean that you are not working out properly. Okay? And we never do workout to tire ourselves. Okay? We want to be, you can say, energetic throughout the day after doing the workout. It is not about the tiredness. If you are tired too much, that means we did a great workout. There is nothing like this. Alright? So, before going for the next set, let me have this water. Now, we are starting with our third set for the squat and knee raise. Again, you have to come in the same position, okay? Or second option that you can just keep your hand over the waist and you can perform this exercise. So I'm showing you this variation also, alright? You can just squat and knee up. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Step. So, this was our last set for the squat and knee raise. And now if we talk about the metabolism, I told you that please don't cut down your calories so drastically, okay? And second way that will help you to increase your metabolism, try to build your muscles, because if you have a good muscles, muscle basically burn at least 6 calories per day, okay? And when it compares it to the fat, it takes only 2 calories, it burns only 2 calories per day. The more muscle mass you have, the best metabolism you have, and for the long term, it will be really helpful for, like, if you are crossing 35 or 40 or whatever, if your metabolism is high, you have a very great advantage. You have seen people also, those who are eating so much also, then also they don't put, because their metabolism is high. Don't compare your metabolism to any other person. This is you, that is your metabolism. Okay? Now, we are going to start with our next exercise. This is known as jump squat. Alright? So you can see, this is again the squat. Okay? And you just have to jump. The people who is having the pain in the knees, please don't try to jump. Okay? Just do this. Just what I'm doing right now. Okay? I'm showing the sideways. You just have to the jump, and then you have to just squat and then jump high up in the air. Alright? So, be normal. You can keep your hand like this also, or you can keep it like this also, as per your convenient level. You can just squat. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Step. So especially if you talk about this exercise basically your landing is very much important. Okay. Just I'm giving you a short tip. So when you're starting with the exercise, you just have to try to put your entire weight on your heels. You can see my toes are up. Alright. So when you keep the entire pressure on your heels, so the body weight is transferred towards our posterior chain, and it will be good for you. The people who is not able to maintain the balance during this exercise, they can just take a pause in between and then they can jump. Alright. The person who are into intermediate level or advanced level, they can just continue the squat, jump, squat and jump. So you can see, I did just only 10 repetitions and my heartbeat is like above 150. So this is the advantage. Alright. So if you do HIIT workout, it will be very good for you. Yes, now we are talking about the metabolism. Try to do some HIIT workout like I am doing it right now. This is HIIT workout. So it's basically help you to increase your metabolism, your resting metabolism. That is most important. It put pressure, okay, on the body so that our resting metabolism starts working very fast. So HIIT workout is very good for you. Now we are going to start with our second set for jump squat. Again, you have to come in the same position. You have to jump. First, you have to squat and then you have to jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Step. So this was our second set for the jump and squat. Now, before going towards the metabolism, guys, these two parameters, your endurance, or you can say the stamina, and your metabolism, these two things are very, very much important. If you are looking for the fat loss, if you're looking for the gaining muscle, if these two factors are very good, then you will rock. Trust me. Okay. Now, how to next level, how we can improve our metabolism more. So the people who think, why I'm drinking water so much in between the set? Because water is one thing that will actually help you in metabolism of the calories. That is why your water is very, very much important. Just make sure that you drink, don't drink too much of water, otherwise when you do the next set, you feel like so much of heaviness in your stomach. So whenever you feel thirsty, or even in the room, if you find like, if you're sweating a lot, if your AC is working, try to cool down, just try to take your heartbeat down. Guys, okay, so this is very much important while doing the workout. You can carry the napkins or something like this so that you just clean up your sweating, whatever is coming. Now, we are going to start with our last set for the jump squat. Alright, so now, again you have to come in the same position. Alright, everything is same. Okay. You have to jump, you have to squat, and then you have to jump. You have to squat, and then you have to jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Squat, jump. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. 9 step. So this is the exercise. You can see I'm using my lower body. Try to keep, whenever you do the squats, make sure your chest is up. Mostly people, when they do the squats, they just take the upper body forward. This is completely wrong, guys. Okay, your chest has to be higher, your hips should be down always. Okay, try to use the muscles of the glutes, because if you more use the glutes, the better arch, or you can say better symmetry will have in the body while with the exercises. Now again, if we talk about the metabolism, what is the another way that we can increase our metabolism? So guys, make sure that you have a small meal. Okay, I've seen people, they just have a meal early morning like 7 a.m. Next meal they are going to have 4 p.m. Or even I've seen the people, they are having the only night meal around 9 p.m. This is absolutely wrong, guys. Never do this mistake. Always try to have some kind of little bit of snacks that will help you to boost up your metabolism. Okay? Our body is not meant for the starving. Never do this mistake. Always make sure that you have a good amount of food and plus in the regular interval. Okay, now this is totally depends on the fitness goal, how you want to go forward. Now we are going for our next exercise. Okay, that is known as bicycle crunch. The people who are obese, who don't able to take their upper body up, you can try this exercise. It will be really good for you. Okay, it basically works on your core. Alright, for this exercise, you have to just lie down on the floor, alright, and completely. This should be the starting position. Your hands should be on the sides, complete tucking in. Okay, now you can, this is the starting position, and one leg should be up like this, and it should be like cycling. One. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you can see that, and my abdominal is basically working on this exercise. Okay, and when you get up from lying to sitting position or even the standing position, always make sure that you first lie down on the sides, easily, slowly, slowly take the support, whatever, if you're lying on the bed or on the floor, just take the support and get up. It will be very good for you so that your lumbar spine, it doesn't hurt. Okay, I've seen people that they hurt their back when they get up from the bed. This is the reason. Don't get up directly forward. Alright, so this exercise, this is just the, you can say, the normal, the beginner level version. I'm going to show you the next level where you can use your upper. The people who are like into intermediate stage or advanced, they can use this thing. It will be very good for them. Okay. Okay, so now we are going to start with our second set. So for this, again, you have to take your hands behind your head, okay, and one leg up, and see, I am keeping my upper body up. You have to touch, one, down, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So as you can see me, when I was start using my upper hand and I just try to touch my elbow to my knees, this will become little bit difficult, little bit challenging. For the guys who are into intermediate level, they can easily do it. But for the obese people or for the beginner people, it will be a bit difficult. Alright? So don't, because the abdominal fat, it will try to stop you from getting up. Okay? So make sure that what I show you the first time, that you can do it. Alright? Now again, how we can increase our metabolism. Now, most important thing, most people think that if they go on the crash diet, it will help them. No guys, never. Your body can respond for like 15 days, 30 days, but trust me, after that, your metabolism goes for entirely for the toss. So please never go for the crash diet. The people who do the crash diet, they're actually slowing down their resting metabolism, and plus body start eating their muscle as a source of energy. So please guys, don't do the crash diet. Please never do that. Now we are starting with our last set for the bicycle crunch. Okay. Again, just keep your chest a little bit up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So this is our bicycle crunch. This is a very basic that you can say for the bicycle crunch. I'll show you one more, you can say the very easy form of the bicycle crunch for the obese people, especially because they are not able to lift their legs completely. So you can actually do the bicycle like in the air, and it will help you to really work on your lower part of the abdominal part. Okay. So I'm just showing you the another form of the bicycle crunch. For this exercise also, just keep your hands aside like this, and you just have to make the bicycle right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So guys, when you do this particular exercise, try to hold your abdominal inside as much as you can. When you do the isometric holding of any of the exercise, it will be really challenging for the body. Okay, and plus you can burn a good amount of calories, and especially for the obese people, if they think that they are not able to lift their legs up completely in the air, make sure you just start with this basic exercise. It will really helpful for you, okay? And you can do it like, literally, you can feel the abdomen that it is burning from inside, okay? Isometric exercise are always good, okay? Now we are moving towards our second set for the bicycle crunch again. Again, 20 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is just the regression form of the bicycle crunch exercise, and it is basically work for the core also and for the lower body also. Okay. Now, when we talk about again the endurance and the stamina, most people think that if they do only cardio, it will help them. No, guys. As I mentioned before also, if you have a good amount of muscle mass, your metabolism will be high. Plus, it will really, you can feel that you are burning something from the body throughout the day. Okay. And people also ask me about the morning workout or the evening workout. So, there is no excess time for the workout, guys. It really depends on your schedule, that how you are following it. But I usually prefer doing in the morning time, because when I do my workout, I can feel that my during the entire day, I feel very much energetic. If I come back from the work also, I don't have a stress that I have to go for my work. Because when we come back from the work, we have so much of, you can see the less energy, and we are not able to perform the exercise. Okay, so I always suggest my clients that if they can do the workout in the morning, it will be very good for them. Alright, now we are starting with our third set for bicep crunch. Keep your chest up, you can see my chest, you can see my proper arch over here. I can put my easily my both hands inside my back, lower back. So this is the arch. Okay, that is very much important, guys. Up again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Strength. The people who is having a lower back pain, they can actually put their hand inside like this. So it will work as a cushion for you guys, and you can actually perform it, this exercise. Okay. So in this way, you can do this exercise. Okay. It will be very good for you. Yes. So, metabolism and your cardiorespiratory endurance, or in normal layman term, your stamina. So guys, always make sure that when you do any kind of like long running, so whatever the guideline that I have shared with you, just try to inculcate in your workout. When you are, suppose if you are going for the half marathon, or if you are going for the long marathon, if you just start using all these tips, it will be really beneficial for you. Okay. Now, I'm just going to show you one more exercise. So basically, you can say that is known as crawling. Okay. So for crawling, you can actually just have to stand in the sideways. Okay. And just keep your legs slightly wider than your hips. And you can perform it. You have to go forward and then you have to come back again using your arms. Alright. You have to go down like this. One, see, you can see my glutes are squeezing it. This is very much important for this exercise. Then again, two, three. Four, five, 6. So you can see me guys, I just did only 10 repetition. So if you do like 15, 20, it totally depends on your fitness level. The more you will do, the more challenging and more tougher it will be for you. Alright? So the people who is having some problems, like if they are not able to go forward, just make sure you just go the halfway and come back. We'll start with our second set. Okay. One. Still. Three. Four. Eight. Nine. Last. Whew. So guys, this is known as stalling. So this is our last exercise. Now we are going towards our cool down phase, guys. This is the very most important. So before I start my cool down, I always start with the breathing, right? Breathe in and breathe out. Stand normally. You can see me guys, how relaxed I am right now. Okay, so that is why breathing is very much important. Now we will just start with the neck stretches. We'll do the every stretches for 10 seconds, we will hold it, then we'll do the opposite side. For the next stretches, just keep your hand like this, your hand, opposite hand, and just stretch your neck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Same with the opposite side, just hold it and just round. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, still. 1. Now we will do the chest static stretches. So for chest, you can just take a support, mind, and just you can just stretch. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. In the same way, you can do the quadriceps standing stretch. Hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is it, guys. I hope you all enjoyed the workout a lot. And whatever. If you feel like, if you have any valuable feedback, please give it to me. If you have any sort of query, what kind of workout you want me to do it, I will definitely do it. Alright? And tomorrow, again, I'm going to come live 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. And please, if you have any questions, query, please drop me. I will definitely going to answer your question. Till then, please take care, have water, and good night.